If you want to learn how to make your Blue Yeti go from
sounding like this to sounding like this
using only free software, then you've come to the right video. I'm Pete from the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, where we have videos explaining everything you need to do to grow your gaming passion into your profession. And today, I'm going to be talking you through all the settings and software that you need to make your Blue microphone sound as professional and production ready as possible. So in this video, we're only going to be using free software. If, however, you're looking for a guide that uses Adobe Audition CC to improve the quality of your microphone, I have got a guide on that as well, which I'll link up in the card above, as well as in the description below, where I'll be putting all the links for this video today. Let's get into it. The programs that we're going to be using today will actually adapt the sound of your microphone on the fly, so you can sound that way whichever program you're using on your computer, be it streaming with OBS or recording voiceovers with something like Audacity, or even talking to somebody over some voiceover internet protocol software such as Skype or TeamSpeak. The two programs are both made by the same company, a company called VB Audio, and if you look in the description of this video, I've got links to the two pieces of software as well as my settings, so I need you to go down to the description and click all three links, and you should be taken firstly to a page looking something like this. We'll start by downloading the virtual audio cable software. So this page, you scroll down until you see the orange button and just click download. The second link for Voicemeeter is the exact same process. Keep scrolling down until you see the orange download button. You can choose to download it as a zip or the exe. I'm going to do the zip. Once you've finished downloading both of these two files, you should have two zip folders, mine saving my downloads, and I'm just going to extract them here using 7-zip. You can use whichever extraction software you like to. Once they're unzipped, you should have two folders, one for VB Cable and one for Voicemeeter. We're going to start with the driver, so double click and open up the folder, and you should see these two files down here, VB Cable Setup and VB Cable Setup X64. Now, some of you might have guessed this is depending on if you have a 32-bit or a 64-bit operating system. If you're not sure what type of operating system you have, you can just right-click the Start menu, go to System, and it should tell you just there which one you have installed. You can see here I have a 64-bit operating system installed. That means that I am going to be installing this file. If you have a 32-bit operating system, you want to be installing this file. Either way, make sure you right-click and run as administrator. A box will pop up asking you to install the driver. Just click Install Driver. And once that's done, you should get a little pop-up just saying installation complete and successful. You might reboot your system to finalize installation. Just click OK. We're going to reboot after we have installed both pieces of software. It'll also pop up a new window just thanking you for installing the product. If you go back to your extracted zip folders and find the Voicemeeter folder and do the exact same thing, right-click, run as administrator. You'll get a similar looking box open up. Just click Install. Once that's installed, you'll get a similar pop-up just telling you that you need to reboot your system, which we will go ahead and do in a second. You can click OK. It will also open up another web page thanking you for installation. Let's now restart our system so that the driver and software install properly. Okay, welcome back. We've just restarted our system to complete the installation of both programs. And now we can just start the Voicemeeter application. So if you search your start menu for Voicemeeter, you should see it open up. Now, don't worry too much if your Voicemeeter application doesn't look exactly like this straight away. This is because it's restored my settings because I've already had the application installed, but we'll get it looking just like this in just a few seconds. The first thing we're going to do is load the settings that you've downloaded from this video description. So wherever you saved the settings, go to Menu, Load Settings, locate the file and click Open. Now it should start to look a little bit more like what I've got in front of me, but maybe these faders aren't going to be moving yet. That's just because we haven't set our hardware input and hardware outputs yet. To set your microphone input, you come up here to hardware input and click the little down arrow next to the one. Here is where you should be selecting your Blue Yeti microphone. Now, usually between the brackets, it will say Blue Yeti for your microphone. For some reason on Windows, mine doesn't seem to actually tell me it's the Blue Yeti, but I know that it is. This USB Audio Class 1 is my Blue Yeti. Yours should say Blue Yeti though. So make sure you select your microphone, and then we'll move on to hardware output. Where it says A1 here on the down arrow, we're going to click And this is where you want to be setting the VB audio virtual cable. So make sure you find that one and select it. And now your bars should be moving around with your voice. If you want to play around with the actual effects, the compressor effects that Voicemeeter applies to your voice, you want to be moving this little red box around the graph here. This basically changes the compressor effects that the Voicemeeter puts onto your voice. So mine is down here in the bottom left. This is just adding a bit of bass and making it sound a little bit more podcasty, but feel free to play around and choose the sound that suits you best. Now at this stage, it's going to be really important for you to understand that whenever you want these effects to be applied to your microphone, you need to have Voicemeeter running. So if you want to set it to start when Windows starts, that's quite a good idea. I just run mine whenever I know I'm going to be using my microphone. So if I'm about to stream with OBS or XSplit, or if I'm recording a voiceover, or even if I'm talking on TeamSpeak and I want to have this really good sounding microphone, I'll start the Voicemeeter application. The second thing you really need to understand is that whichever application you're using your microphone in, this could be in a game or again in OBS or Skype or any program where you're going to be using your microphone, you need to make sure that the microphone input is actually set to Voicemeeter output, not to your Blue Yeti. To demonstrate this, I'm going to open up Audacity. If we go up to the settings here where we're choosing our microphone input, you can see I have both the option of Voicemeeter output as well as my Blue Yeti microphone. If I just select the Blue Yeti microphone here, it's not going to be applying the Voicemeeter effects. So you need to be selecting the Voicemeeter output to be getting the effects from the program. I'm going to demonstrate the difference between both of these sounds now for you. So we're going to start with just the Blue Yeti and no Voicemeeter application. And now I'll record using Voicemeeter. Let's listen to these back.
This is how my mic sounds without Voicemeeter running. And this is how my mic sounds with Voicemeeter running.
Hopefully you can hear the difference between those two and you can play around with the Voicemeeter settings to really make sure you're getting the sound of it that you want. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching. If you found the video helpful, please give it a thumbs up because that helps us know which kind of content you guys enjoy. We can make more of it in the future. Also, if you're new here to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, have a look around. We've got loads of videos helping you grow your YouTube channel, grow your Twitch audience, and generally turn your gaming passion into a profession. If that's the kind of content that you guys enjoy, then be sure to click subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace.